False River has been described as a Bildungsroman by proxy. So it's very strongly based on autobiographical experience, set in South Africa starting in the early 70s and sort of following chronologically the life of a brother and sister very close to each other, growing up in a quite remote rural area of South Africa during the apartheid years. And it tells the story of the brother kind of coming to age as the country comes into liberation in 94. My older brother Paul, who's the main character in the book, was such a kind of charismatic, talented figure, and he was the right of the family. You know, he wrote wonderful poetry when he was still young in high school. So I think one sort of put yourself a bit in the shade of that bigger talent. And funnily enough, although the desire was there, I never really gave voice to it until I had a sense after his death that even his voice was fading. So in some way, his disappearance sort of perhaps allowed me to emerge. There's a very strong tradition of poetry in Afrikaans writing, and a sort of a great love for it and wonderful poets in our literature. So it is the kind of writing that appeals to me. It's almost like I like the music and the writing. It's nothing really necessarily needs to happen for me to like. I think that there's definitely an ethical question that comes into play when you are writing about people close to you and known lives. And I don't think it's an ethical question that's necessarily resolved very easily, but I think it's forgiven if people feel that the writing is of a good enough standard. At the same time, I think that it's very hard for writers not to write about what they know. So you can either be disingenuous and disguise it, but the people who will recognize themselves will recognize themselves anyway. So I think I made it difficult for the reader because I left that problem in the reader's lap, because it is, I think the distinction between memoir and biography and autobiography and fiction is fluid. You know, there aren't these distinct divisions. And I think that if you convey or you portray your characters in all their kind of complexity and humanity, and you also expose yourself, I think that you can get away with it. I think that what I also did is the very clear characters that are present there is Paul and my parents. Everybody else, to an extent, is sort of faded out a little bit. There are also these conflations of places, of different events. So there's a lot of fictional infill that's sort of put on top of the architecture, which is based on real events. My father wrote me a long email after I sent him the manuscript to correct everything that I'd done wrong. And my mother's, I think for my mother it was hard to revisit those painful memories. So she preferred, they've been extremely supportive. Everyone's been incredibly supportive of my desire to write. And I think there's in an Afrikaans expression you say, I don't write from outside of the home, I write from within the heart. Well, I think one of the first things you realize when you start writing and you're using your memory as an archive, you realize that it's full of holes. So memory not only disappears, it also changes. And though you assume certain things seem so obvious, even the sort of physical signs, for example, of apartheid, the way it used to be where, you know, you had signs, whites only, you know, all those things were kind of removed. So almost in the same way, the past gets constantly edited. So sometimes you really have to question yourself, am I remembering this correctly, or, you know, is it something that I remember in a way that I want to remember it? But we certainly lived very much within a very conservative society in which we were different because we didn't agree with the politics. And it made our family stand kind of outside of our community to an extent. So it was a very intense daily lived experience of racism, that which is very hard to forget.